If you're sick, you go to a doctor. Most people do. I don't. I go to a mental doctor. Dr. Jesus is a mental doctor, actually. The mind that believes it can be sick, it is very insane, actually. And the remedy that I'm given are these affirmations, prayers, affirmations. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened. Now, the mind that doesn't believe it's already enlightened is crazy, because we're still spirit exactly as God created us. To believe that we're not already enlightened is to believe in time, plain and simple. And time is simply idle, silly wishes. Silly, meaningless, silly wish. To believe in time, space, process, and form. So, to the extent that we believe in time, the mind is still very sick indeed, and needs quote-unquote healing. To the extent that we believe that we're a body, we believe we're in a world, to that extent we are entertaining these silly, idle thoughts, meaningless thoughts, and worshiping time. So what we have to do is to diminish our time worshiping. Diminish our time worshiping. And the way to do that, the ultimate way, is to say, I'm already enlightened. Meaning, I don't need any time at all to be what I am. I do not need any time at all to be what I am. This is the strongest medicine. And we need strong medicine right now. I don't recommend lesser medicines at this situation. This dynamic that we have now in the world is very heavily based on time worshiping, and it's like a disease. It's like everyone's minds. The world the dynamic is that of a very sick mind. And sick minds tend to get contagious. If you live with people who have sick minds, you tend to get that way. And so you have to make every effort. You have to take very strong medicine right now. But which is fine. It's okay. The people were worrying, why I take this medicine? Maybe I'm going. This going to. What do you mean? I'm already enlightened. Well, very simple. I am already enlightened. I am already free. I am already free. I'm already free. I've been working with this, so I'm just passing on what I've already been working on here. And I've not experienced negative effects. Just the opposite. I've felt myself being able to calm down and realize, hey, there is a way to regain sanity. And you do it and say, I'm already sane. I've already regained my sanity. So you take time out of the equation. The way to get free of time is to take time out of the equation. Not to keep using time. Ultimately, we can use time to diminish delay to a certain extent. But at some point, you reach diminishing returns where the using of time keeps the belief in time going. So at some point you have to say, hey, wait a minute. I don't need any body thoughts. I'm not a body. What do I need body thoughts for? See, all thoughts are body thoughts, world thoughts. I don't need thoughts. In fact, I already don't have any thoughts. I already don't have any thoughts. And so you imagine as if you already are free of time. And put yourself mentally in that position of, I'm already free of body thoughts. And when you see these body thoughts arising, thinking, you say, that has nothing to do with me. Body, I have no business with body thoughts whatsoever. In fact, I don't even have any business with thoughts whatsoever. I'm already free of thoughts. I'm already free of thoughts. I dwell in bliss. I'm already dwelling in bliss. So I have no business whatsoever with any of that. I've never been a body. See, I'm already free. I'm already free. I've never been a body. I've always been complete. I have no needs to finish anything at all. I don't have any need to finish. I've already finished. So whenever we use a term, a time term, like finish, I need to finish, say, whoa, 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 whoa. I've already finished. So knocks time out of the equation. We're not going to the extent of saying, I never started. I mean, that follows, that realization follows. But that may be too big of a leap for us. So when we say, I've already finished, we're at least saying, well, you know, I'm not saying, I'm setting time off to the side, that it's a moot point at this, it's a moot at this point, you see. It's not important anymore. How long did I take all this? No, I've already finished. That's the only important thing. I've already finished. So the discussion about finishing is off the board. See, and that takes time out of the equation. Because time is a dream of bodies and form and process, time, space, process and form, worlds, bodies. All of this is an attempt to get rid of guilt. We are dreaming this dream to try to get rid of this feeling of guilt, which we felt when we tried to change what we were, what we are. Tried to change what we are, we had this feeling of guilt, and we thought we could use bodies to get rid of this guilt. It doesn't work. The body is neutral, doesn't do anything. The body doesn't think any thoughts. It's the mind that's thinking body thoughts. Those thoughts are not coming from the body, actually. But we project them upon the body, so it seems as if they're coming from the body. The body is actually nothing at all. It's just like a neutral shell, a husk or something like that. So we say, I don't have any body thoughts. That means in the mind, I don't need any body thoughts. I'm already free of the body. I'm already free of the body. I'm already free. So this is strong medicine, but it's very takeable, very takeable. This is the prescription that the Holy Spirit wrote for me. I asked for a prescription for this next 18-month period, the second quarter of the tribulation period really we're in. And this is the prescription the Holy Spirit wrote for me. So I said, wow, I better take it. And this is what Dr. Jesus has recommended. Say, you need to try this. Ultimately, you need to take a leap of faith, which is to say, I'm already here. How did I get rid of time? I've already gotten rid of it. It's finished. It's already finished. There doesn't need to be any questions. Questions have no relevance because I've already done it. And I realized that time has no business. I don't have any business with time whatsoever. So what am I doing answering questions? Time is asking me questions. I don't need to answer any questions. I'm already free of time. I'm already enlightened. I'm already enlightened. So working with this, one can begin to get a little deeper, a little deeper. I'm starting to get a little deeper, a little deeper. I don't need any body thoughts whatsoever. Body thoughts, world thoughts, that's all time. I don't need it, I've already finished. So to me, that none of that's relevant anymore. See, I've already finished. That's already irrelevant. Body thoughts are already irrelevant. And it's this that enables one to go into bliss, actually. Because without body thoughts, what is there? Bliss. That's inherent. I'm already blissful. I'm already blissful. I don't need to figure out how to be blissful. You see, time and space is designed to figure something out. There's nothing I need to figure out. I'm already blissful. I'm already enlightened. I don't need to figure it out. There's no need to figure it out. There's no need for us to figure out what we are. We already are what we are. I already am. I already am. I am. Not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So we don't need any answers because there's no question. I'm already free of questions. I'm already free of all questions. this is something to feel, to practice and to feel and to imagine. I'm already free of all questions. I'm already question free. So, like a medicine, like a therapy program, take it every day. You take people on, who have medical issues, they take their medicine every day or twice a day. They don't miss. And so you just look at so many people in the world, how many are taking medicine every day without missing? So how is it that we cannot take our medicine every day without missing? Are we somehow so inferior to those who take physical pills, we cannot take a spiritual pill every day? What is that? They take it because they know if they don't, they may die. You see? Well, if we don't take this spiritual pill every day, we may find ourselves with very sick minds. And that's worse than death. It's worse than death. Sick mind is worse than death, because it will keep believing that it needs to keep using bodies and get more and more enmeshed in body thoughts, and that more and more enmeshed in time and space process and form, more and more worshiping time, which keeps it distracted from what it, from spirit. So you will not feel this question free, blissful, seamlessly satisfied feeling. You'll continue to be struggling, and with attack thoughts, vulnerability thoughts, fear thoughts of all different types. So, it's not a big deal to do this every day, just like a person takes their pills to deal with medical conditions every day. We don't like pin a gold ribbon on them and say, "Wow, you're incredible. You take pills every day. That's amazing." No, I just realized that I got to do this. I have to do this. The doctor said I have to do this. In order to live, so I'm going to do it. So we're no less under any obligation to take the spiritual pill every day. Now, I put up a lot of videos using Ramana Maharshi, who is someone who's free of all body thoughts, all world thoughts, all time thoughts, as in blissful. His thoughts are all blissful. Behind Ramana Maharshi represents body thoughts. The video behind Ramana Maharshi represents time, belief in time, body thoughts, form thoughts. And so he was able to be in this world with all these supposed you know, time worshiping body thoughts, form thoughts, process thoughts, it's all body thoughts, he was able to maintain the blissful thought of oneness. He's able to do this. So it is possible to do this, actually. It is possible to be free of body thoughts, even while in this world. Ramana Maharshi proved it. So, in watching these videos, you can realize what's going on. You're saying, you know, I can be this way, like Ramana Maharshi, too. Even though there's all these body thoughts in the world, time-worshipping thoughts going on, I don't need any of those thoughts. I'm already enlightened. I don't need any of those thoughts to be what I already am. I'm already enlightened, so I don't need those thoughts. If I'm already enlightened, I don't need those thoughts, do I? I'm finished. I'm already finished. I don't need any more of those thoughts. You see how this works? Since I've already finished, I don't need any of those thoughts. I'm already enlightened. I'm already free. I'm already free of body thoughts, so I don't need the body thoughts. I'm already done with all that. So they're no longer necessary. So we can be like Ramana Maharshi. Absolutely we can. Ramana Maharshi has this presence, where when you look at Ramana Maharshi, you really, for at least for me, I think a lot of people, a lot of us, you don't really feel any body thoughts towards him at all. It just doesn't arise, which I find him very helpful in this regard. Because mostly it's just you're looking at his eyes, his expression, and you just realize, wow, he doesn't have any body thoughts at all. He really doesn't have any body thoughts at all. Okay, time thoughts are saying, gotta do this, I've gotta do this too. But, so in looking at Ramana Maharshi, this seems to be not really any body thoughts tend to arise. So it's very helpful. It's very, very helpful for us. So behind him, all this stuff is going on. And we see this and we may be attracted to it for a while. But gradually, practice, and you practice the videos. You can watch them over and over. You can listen with music if you want to. But gradually you start focusing in on, hey, I don't need this stuff. I there's something better for me. Bliss thoughts. Thoughts I think with God. Not body thoughts. Spirit thoughts. I can have that instead. In fact, I'm already finished with body thoughts. I already have bliss. Begin to say, I'm already blissful. And so then get your attention more to what Ramana Maharshi is shining to us, which is, I'm already blissful. And all this stuff that's going on in the world, doesn't matter, I don't need it anymore, I'm finished. I've already finished. It's not that I'm finishing, no, I've already finished. It's already done. It's already over. I already have the result I'm looking for, which is bliss. I already have it. So I don't need any of this stuff. So these are practice videos. Now certainly the background's moving and all these colors and stuff is like, wow, this is beautiful. Okay. We'll be distracted. So you have to work at it. Work at it. So you're less and less distracted and you see all the stuff. So, yeah, but that's not what I really want. It's kind of cool. It's really cool stuff, bubbles and stuff, and beautiful nature. But that's not what I really want. I want what Ramana Maharshi has. He has something better that is thoughts that we think with God. Bliss. I'm already in bliss. I'm already experiencing bliss. Don't say, go past, I want it. Say, no, I already have it. Therefore, this other stuff is just not even relevant at all to me. It's just irrelevant. I don't need it. I'm already enlightened. I don't need unenlightenment. See, I'm already enlightened. I don't need unenlightenment. And all the past that seem to arise out of unenlightenment, out of time. Time spins endless past. Okay. I don't need any of those past. I don't need time. It's already finished. It's over. It's done. I'm already enlightened. I'm already blissful. So, these videos are for you for practice. When you want to try to let me work on this. This is available, many videos available. Every day practice at this point right now in the world. There's you take your pill, it's like medicine. If you don't take it, your blood pressure's gonna go way too high or something like that. There's no excuse, I don't want any excuses. People excuse, well, there's no help, there's nobody that, nonsense. It's like saying, I can't take medicine, there's no medicine at the pharmacy. Oh, sure there is. Well, this is like a spiritual pharmacy. There's medicine here. So, however feeble the attempts are, you will find that as you make the attempt, you start to get better. Just like anything, you start practicing guitar, you never played it, you feel like you're just an idiot. But gradually you start being able to play, do some things, say, hey, I can make some music here. So, I am not a body, I am free. I am already free. This is the emphasis of, I'm already blissful. I'm already finished, I've already done, it's already done deal. I'm already enlightened. So we will keep beating the drum for this. Super, super important to actually go ahead and make the effort, because in hindsight, you And hindsight will show you either I made the effort or I didn't make the effort. 18 months from now, we'll look back and say, well, it'd be easy to know. Did I make the effort or did I not make the effort? And you will know it's going to be one or the other, not both. You say, well, yeah, I did, but I didn't. No, either I did or I did not make the effort. So we want to be able to look back 18 months from now and say, you know what, I did make the effort. Absolutely. In fact, I already succeeded. And we start by saying right now, I've already succeeded. This is the effort by saying, I already succeeded. It's already done. It's already happened. And you see, what are we doing? We're knocking time out of the picture entirely. We're knocking the entire cosmic time right off the board, sweeping it right off the board, erasing it. It's already happened. It has already happened. And now I do have to go take care of some business, but it has already happened. Practice, 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 practice. No matter how feeble it feels, you will start gaining momentum as you keep at it, keep at it. You have some humor, and if you need whatever you need to, but remember, at some point you're going to have hindsight, and you're going to have to answer the question: did I practice or did I not? Did I do it or did I not do it? And the answer will be staring you right in the face. So, just do it, as they say. That's it.